Hi everyone, welcome to HDpiano, this is Joe. Today we are learning how to play Rainbow by Kacey Musgraves. This is an extremely heartfelt piece of music. Intro and first verse coming up. 3, 4. Then we're into the chorus. Pretty song this one, wowee. Don't listen to much country music, country and western music over here in the UK, but I have a little soft spot for it. I was sort of raised on it almost, but I've long forgotten most of that. But yeah, it's very stirring. Anyway, this is middle C. Hello middle C, this is in the key of E flat major, so we've got B flats, E flats, and A flats to think about. I was struggling to think of a question for this because I don't really know much about country and western music, but then I thought about the subject matter and how, looking on the YouTube comments, this is obviously a piece of music that affects people extremely deeply, and it's also quite a positive song. So what other songs are there that really sort of like strike a chord with you but are positive? So not necessarily songs that are, I don't know, like Johnny Cash's Hurt, where it's all about like the regrets in your life, but something that's actually positive, like this one. The sky is falling open, or the sky is finally open, the rain and wind stop blowing, but there's a rainbow over your head, mate. Probably not mates, were they? They probably were more than mates. Anyway, enough ramble. E flat major, first position, is our right hand starting point. And this is an accompaniment, by the way, very much so. If you've got a beautiful voice, then sing along like Kacey Musgraves. And we start off with this in the right hand. 1, 2, and 3, 4, and... So the right hand is doing first position E flat majors the whole time. The left hand, octave, 2 and 3, 4. And so we go from E flat major here to change the bottom note to a C, and it becomes C minor 7, just like that. Last time, 1, 2, and 3, 4. Then this lovely A flat sus 2, 3, 3. Like that. So A flat sus 2 with a fifth of A flat. 2, and then E flat major with an E flat 5. 3, and like that. 1, 2, and 3, 4. Last time with that bar. 2, and 3, 4. Then E flat again. 2, E, and 3. And so our first 16th, 1, 2, E, and 3, 4. And again, just going between E flat major, 2, E, and to C minor 7, like that. And then the end of the intro is just 3 A flat sus 2s in root position with an A flat 5, just like that, closing out the final bar of that 4-bar phrase. Last time, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now you're into the verse, so quieten down a bit. 1, 2, 3, 4. So just E flat 1 in the right hand with E flat in the bass. The C minor 7, using the same chord but a C in the bass. That's E flat 1, the C minor 7, and that's 5, 7, 3. Then A flat sus 2 again, 2 and 3, 4, and then this time a bit more of a resolve, because we just after the A sus 2 here, we do our E flat first position, but nothing else. That's A flat sus 2, and then E flat 1, last time with that bar. Then we carry on. 1, 2, and C minor 7, 4, and so that bar, nice simple offbeat pattern in the left hand, or on-off, I should say, with quarter notes in the right hand. Just like that. Then, A flat sus 2 again, and a different chord. We've got A flat sus 2 the first half of that bar, here, 2, and then B flat 11. We've got the B flat, root, 3, 5 comes in a minute, but then this 4th. 4th on the 3rd in the same chord, the 4th is not a sus 4, it's an 11. So that is 1, 2, and B flat 3rd with a 4th on it, think of it like that. You get confused. So A flat sus 2, B flat 3 with a 4th on it. Again, A flat sus 2. B flat 11. Then this, T minor 2, G7 out of key. Let's look at that again. C minor second inversion, and then G7. I say it's out of key because, of course, we should have a B flat there. So if you've played it with the B flat and kept it diatonic, as in key, it would sound like that. But they've quite sensibly augmented that note, and you get that lovely sound. So C minor second inversion, and then G7, this is 7-3-5, like that. C minor second inversion, and then G7. And then, bar of 2-4, finishing the video with a bar of 4-4. That bar of 2-4, we've got C second inversion, 1, and then the same again on beat 2, C second inversion, but this time with the 7th in the bottom, B flat. And then 4 beats of another chord that's breaking the key signature, because of course it should be minor, but they sensibly made it major, which sounds lovely. T minor with B flat, i.e. C minor 7, F7. So F major triad with a minor 7. Again. Play that for 4 beats. 3-4. So it's 1-2-1-2-3-4. Last time. And that's the proper speed. And that is the entire of the introduction and the first verse. So I think we should probably hear it again. Here it is. 3-4. There we go, everyone. A very pretty song, this one. And it's got lots of sort of fairly similar parts. I haven't quite decided the order of them just yet, but it's not too much to bear. I'll see you on the next video anyway. This has been Joe, HDpiano. If you're on YouTube, head on over to hdpiano.com to see the other parts of this and then discover many more like it and beyond. Thanks, guys. See you on the next one. Bye for now.